Hey, what's up, you guys, and welcome back once again to the final video here in Zach Month. For the final video in Zach Month, I decided I wanted to do something a little bit different, kind of have a little bit of a montage video instead of our direct storyline videos we've had the past couple weeks. So folks, I gathered some clips, and now we are heading into the archives. To start things off, we might as well show some moments celebrating Zach a little bit. So here's a clip of Lewis and Zach and just a little bit too much cake. Take a look.
Boom.
Somebody stuck their dick in the camera.
Why would you say that? Hey, this is only fair.
What the frick?
Hey, come on. Go ahead.
Out of the middle of the road, though.
Right there, Zach.
Right there.
Zach, you ready?
What?
Zach, smile.
For what?
Smile at the cameras. Yeah, baby, graduation, baby!
Oh man, nothing's gonna beat Nick saying somebody stuck their dick in that cake. That still cracks me up even today. Continuing on the celebration train, we've got a clip from Zach's birthday a few years ago where I made Zach a pretty cool gift and kind of snuck a little surprise in there. Take a look.
You're gonna push it through?
Just push him through. Just loosen it up.
Okay. Flip them around, you can kind of see. Wow, so they got BT on this side, and then the Q of A kind of blew on that side. Made a bunch of them.
What?
Yeah, so you can kind of go through and see all of them. And, you know, look at all the engraving. They're coasters, so you put your stuff on them, you know?
This is insane.
You can just kind of go through. They stick a little bit because of the polyurethane, yeah. But here, we can send them out, you know?
This is awesome, though.
You see all the details of everything.
Oh, this is so cool, Tom. Oh my god, there's no way. Starts in like 45 minutes.
Yeah. What do you think we're fucking doing tonight?
We're going to the strip club.
Yes, we are.
See, I've been spending the entire week telling Zach, oh yeah, I'm taking him to the strip club for his birthday, and then just to surprise him with some Hawks tickets, I know that definitely made his day. Moving right along, if there's one thing we all know and love about Zach, it's the fact that he can get jiggy out on the dance floor. So why not take the time to highlight some of those moments by looking at a few clips here. It's always life is a highway. That's how you get Zach crunk. Life is a highway inside the car. The woo. Oh, that's everything.
Oh my god, you're moving.
What? I can't hear you.
Well, of course you can't hear me. You got the music too loud. He's just going. Oh my god. I kind of like, I want to stop it, but at the same time, I don't want to stop it because it's just like too perfect. Everything.
All night long.
And
you're going my way. I wanna drive it all night long.
Oh, that clip was just absolutely phenomenal. I mean, that is Zach in a nutshell. Always dancing, doing a little bit of karaoke in the car. I wonder what this clip is. Let's jump into this next clip here. See, Zach's got all the moves. Oh man, I think this is another one of him like actually in the line here. Look at him go. He's just right in there. He's got all the moves. This just reminds me that I don't dance among any circumstances whatsoever, and it makes me happy to see Zach dancing. What's this final clip?
Where is this going?
Oh Lord. I I film Zach way too much, and that's very clear from that video right there. He's wanted to know where I'm putting everything. Well, Zach, it's going on YouTube. Now, if there are two sound bites that I could take from Zach to summarize Zach pretty much over 50% of the time with him, it would be
boo.
And
let me see what's on the menu.
So why not take the time to show Zach in a little bit more of a professional food setting by doing a few of Zach's food reviews? The first food review actually comes from a place pretty much everyone has been to once in their lifetime, and that is McDonald's, with a rather interesting concoction by Zach himself.
Go ahead.
Can you send this to me?
Yeah, sure, I'll send it to you.
Yeah, I construct the land, air, and sea burger. First, you take your Big Mac, put that aside, right? Then you take the Filet-O-Fish. I believe you just take, yeah, leave that there. You take out this half of the burger, take the Filet-O-Fish. Pop it on like that. Get the sauce. Like that. And that can just sit there. Yep. Then put it back on. Right?
Right.
You take the pickles off because you're not a monster. Well, I'll leave one on for the experience, you know?
Yeah.
But then you take McChicken.
He had to actually go and check which one was which.
Yeah. You take the McChicken, you just take the bun, just the chicken part, put it on top like that.
Okay.
And that's it.
So we assemble the first one.
This is the land, air, and sea burger. Pretty good, huh?
Yeah.
All right. How do I eat this?
I don't know. You can't eat it upside down like you typically do.
What do you mean? I could. You just gotta really smush it down.
Okay, you smush it down. Your analysis?
I don't really know what I'm eating right now.
You gonna go in for another bite?
Give me a second. I need a
process. Oh, yep. Don't forget the Sprite. I put the napkins there for you for a reason.
You're so right. Thank you. Yeah, I'm just trying to figure out what I'm eating, really. I'm just trying to figure that out.
Mm-hmm.
Like, what am I actually eating right now?
I don't know.
Is it food? Is it...
I would hope it is.
Is it a gift from God?
Oh my God, what a jump.
The chicken's actually the hardest part to taste. I can taste the Filet-O-Fish and the burger. The chicken's actually pretty difficult.
Interesting.
Mmm. The middle bite. Mmm, that's a good bite.
That was a good bite?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's a little
too. So we can't taste the air, which isn't shocking, but we can taste the land and the sea.
Well, realistically, air? Chickens don't even fly.
I mean, like, long distances, sure, but they can fly.
I just don't even know what's happening to me right now.
Do you want to attempt the other one?
All right, let's
before
try
to finish. Let's construct the other one.
Yeah.
I don't think we have the barbecue sauce, but we'll do ketchup instead.
You a big barbecue sauce guy?
Not really.
Okay.
It doesn't even really matter. Oh, give me a second. Did you have ketchup in your bag?
Yeah.
Do you have a spare ketchup or no?
No, okay. I don't.
You know what? I don't even need it.
You don't need it? Okay.
I think ketchup's probably on this.
Let's just see. Yep, yeah. There's ketchup on it. We're not even concerned.
Not even concerned.
All right, so what's this?
This is a lot more tame. This is the, this is the crunchy double. It's a lot more tame.
Okay.
You literally just take this part off. You take your nuggets. Ooh, these are kind of like dark. And you just start plopping them on it.
Yep, let's get some action.
Try to fit nice good amount. We could save those.
Yep.
Normally you just put barbecue sauce on it and then you fill it like this. And that's it.
Okay.
That's pretty simple.
Here we go.
I've actually done this before.
And how was that?
This actually tastes like something.
Oh, okay.
Like I can actually taste all the
individual
parts.
Absolutely.
Which like, yeah, that's a McDouble with nuggets on it. I don't know what that is. I still don't really know what
that is.
That's like, you know, that's like a potion.
Right, totally. So, what would you rate this $20 experience out of 10?
This is pretty good.
That doesn't answer my question. I said out of 10.
This is like a... It's like a 9. 9?
Wow.
It's like an 8.5.
8.5, okay, interesting. Like we went down a half.
It's like 8.25.
8.25, we're going down 3/4 from where we started.
That's good. It's only because I'm still trying to figure out what that is.
Do you want to try it again to see
try
what
it
is? Yeah.
Try it.
We can try it again. You figured it out yet?
It's kind of like the battle pass.
It's kind of like the battle pass.
Yeah.
Right.
Play battle pass.
Okay.
Well, yeah, that's pretty much it.
Anything else?
Go Hawks.
That's it?
Yeah.
Okay. There we go.
I will have to say, sitting through Zach going through and concocting all of these different McDonald's secret recipes off of the items on the menu was probably one of the weirdest moments of my life. The next food review is of a corn dog, but like a really, really weird corn. I'm just gonna go ahead and let Zach explain it to you.
Cow.
Okay.
Corn dogs by Mr. Cow.
Right.
We got the fried potato.
Yep.
With sugar and ketchup.
What's in the inside?
100% beef. We went with the all beef.
Okay.
I might need a napkin.
You might need a napkin? Is that what you said?
I might need a napkin.
Okay. Well, I got some napkins for you. Go ahead. Did you even eat the...
I don't got it all.
Your thoughts?
Hot.
Here goes in for another bite. Let's get some up close action.
That chewing there. Mm-hmm. Yep, that tongue. Yep. Mm-hmm.
Does it work with the 100% all beef hot dog?
Mm-hmm.
All right. You gonna give it a go with the, what did you have in there, cheese balls? Is it, how many is in there?
Four
cheese balls.
With honey butter.
Honey butter on them, all right. Give it a go.
It's
What would you rate that out of 10?
That's like an 8.
All right. And where would you rate the corn dog?
The corn dog? A little big. Hard to eat.
Yep.
But the beef is good. Potatoes are nice. I did get sugar. I don't really know what the sugar did. I'll give it a 7.5.
7.5 out of 10. You heard it here, folks. Zachary Murawski, professional food reviewer.
And Zach truly is a professional food reviewer. I'm actually very happy with how well I shot the corn dog one there. It's fairly descriptive in terms of what you get to see from Zach eating this stuff. And I know I would personally never try it in my life, but you know, I'm happy that it brings Zach some joy. And for our final clip of this monstrous Zach month montage, I wanted to show you guys a clip of Zach drunk as shit. Take a look.
You're not that drunk?
Yeah. All right.
Yeah. So explain Exploding Kittens to me.
So Exploding Kittens is a game where you have to not touch the exploding kitten.
Uh-huh.
Not draw the black card.
Uh-huh.
There's four of us. There should be three exploding kittens in the deck. And what you do is you draw last. Drawing the cards at the end of your turn. And you basically utilize a bunch of cards in your deck during your turn to avoid touching the kitten. And that's pretty good, honestly. You have a defuse, and the last one to touch the kitten wins.
Yeah.
Now, how does this affect LeBron's legacy?
So, LeBron is actually worse than Austin Reeves. I've said he's actually worse than Austin Reeves.
Can you explain?
Austin Reeves might be the next Michael Jordan.
He might be the next Michael Jordan. You can't say that with a straight face.
Austin Reeves is the next Michael Jordan. Because he knows ball.
He knows ball. No other reason. What's your name?
I'm Zach Murawski, and I know ball.
Zach Murawski knows ball. I think that's all I needed. All
right.
Man, I tell you what, he did explain how exploding kittens work. I gotta give him credit for that, but oh boy, he was having a good night. He was having a good night. And folks, not only is that gonna wrap up this video, that is gonna wrap up 2024 Zach month. I'm super excited that we made it all the way through. So if you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button down below and turn on the post notifications to join the Bridge Gang. Comment down below your favorite memories with Zach and your favorite parts of Zach month as well. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Bye!